fire shots at CM Punk in Chicago, and MJF calls out UFC megastar Conor McGregor. But first, let's get to the quickfire headlines, as Kenny Omega would speak with Sports Illustrated this week ahead of his return at New Japan Pro Wrestling at Wrestle Kingdom 17. Omega will take on the heir to his top gaijin throne, Will Ospreay, for the IWGP US title, and during the interview, he would give his thoughts on his opponent, and he would say, "I left to start this new exciting opportunity, but it's still home. Now, the things Will Ospreay can do are things I cannot. He's an athletic phenom, but as finely tuned as he is physically, he still doesn't have the knowledge or experience. I pushed my own physical boundaries in All Japan and DDT, but that's not what I'm known for. My mind is my greatest asset, not my athleticism. That's what's allowed Hiroshi Tanahashi to have such a long and flavorful career. I needed someone to take my place in New Japan. I wanted someone to take my place, and it was Will, Jay White, and Kota Ibushi. Will is the only one to have a problem with that." And speaking of Wrestle Kingdom, New Japan have announced that the event will now take place over two nights, with the second night being more than 2 weeks after night one on January 4th. Night two is set for January 21st from the Yokohama Arena, with NJPW talent battling the stars of Pro Wrestling Noah, this being similar to night three of Wrestle Kingdom earlier this year at the same arena. After raiding MJF in his AEW World Championship win over Jon Moxley this past weekend at Full Gear, William Regal would appear on AEW Dynamite last night to address the situation. He would confirm that Friedman won't be on the show in Chicago, with him instead being on the set of a major motion picture, but he will be in attendance next week. Regal would then be confronted by Jon Moxley, who was out for blood, before fellow Blackpool Combat Club member Bryan Danielson was able to call the situation. Moxley would tell Regal to run far away and never come back, refraining from acting on his instincts. Whilst we don't know why Regal helped MJF in the end, he did reveal that the deal was put together through email. Orange Cassidy would put his AEW All-Atlantic title on the line against Jake Hager of the Jericho Appreciation Society before successfully retaining the belt. After the match came to a close, QT Marshall and the Factory would interrupt the celebrations of the best friends before they were interrupted themselves by the returning House of Black. This was Malakai Black, Buddy Matthews, Brody King, and Julia Hart's first appearance in 2 months, with the house wiping out both the heel and babyface teams, a sign that nobody is safe. The final of the AEW World Title Eliminator Tournament was held on the show, where Ricky Starks was able to overcome the challenge of Ethan Page to be crowned the number one contender for MJF's World Championship. The match will go down at the Winter Is Coming edition of Dynamite on December 14th in what will be Starks' first ever match for the AEW World Title. During the show, Renee Paquette would announce that AEW Women's World Champion Thunder Rosa has been stripped of her title, this after being out for a prolonged period of time, before Renee revealed that the interim champion Jamie Hayter is now the official champion. Rosa has been absent since August before being out due to injury, with Tony Storm later winning the interim belt. Commentary also confirmed that Tony's reign has retroactively been officially recognized, removing the interim stamp from her resume. In the main event of the show, Chris Jericho would defend his Ring of Honor World Championship against New Japan Pro Wrestling star Tomohiro Ishii, who is a former ROH television champion. In the end, the champion would retain after a bloody bout that saw Jericho's chest be bust open before he managed to win with the Lion Tamer. Jericho would then storm up the ramp, seemingly with his eye on commentator Ian Riccaboni, before Claudio Castagnoli cut him off, who appears to be Jericho's next challenger at Final Battle on December 10th. Now let's get back to the Thunder Rosa situation, as Dave Meltzer would provide an update on her return from injury on Wrestling Observer Radio, revealing why she was stripped of her AEW World Championship, and he would say, "The deal with Rosa was that when she went down, she was going to lose the title at All Out to Toni Storm. They expected her to be back in November-December, and I think the feeling was, because of what happened with CM Punk, where they gave him a couple of months, to be consistent, they would have to do the same thing here. Now it's looking like February, so I think they're saying February's too long." According to Fightful Select, AEW star Scorpio Sky is now recovered from a leg injury that has kept him out of action for nearly 5 months, with his last appearance taking place on AEW Dynamite on July 6th, where he dropped the AEW TNT title to Wardlow. According to the report, while Sky is back to full health, there are currently no creative plans in place for his return. It was noted that he was in attendance at an episode of Dynamite over the summer where he filmed some content, although this didn't end up airing on the show. AEW president Tony Khan would appear on Unrestricted podcast this week, where he provided an update on the status of Ring of Honor. Khan would reveal that he's still working on a television deal for the promotion and said, "I'm open to different things, but I've been very open about the fact that I'm interested in weekly Ring of Honor television in addition to what we're doing now with Warner Brothers Discovery. It has been a very lucrative partnership we're pursuing because so far this has been on a per event basis, the greatest year of Ring of Honor pay-per-view history. I think there is a business case for it in a way that does not cannibalize AEW pay-per-views or live events." Speaking on his To Be The Man podcast this week, WWE Hall of Famer Ric Flair would reveal that he will be in attendance at the upcoming Royal Rumble in January and has been invited to the 30th anniversary of Monday Night Raw the week before. The exact nature of his appearances are not yet known, but this will be his first WWE cameo since his release in August 2021 and the subsequent Dark Side of the Ring controversy. And next, the Elite fire shots at CM Punk in Chicago. Last night, Kenny Omega and the Young Bucks would make their return to AEW Dynamite for the first time since the all-out backstage altercation involving the Elite, CM Punk, and Ace Steel, with the show going down in Punk's hometown of Chicago. Throughout the match and the show, both pro and anti-CM Punk chants would break out, showing that even his hometown is divided on the situation. On the night, the Elite would compete in match 2 of the ongoing Best of 7 series for the Death Triangle's AEW Trios Championships, although they would fall short, making the scores 2-0. Despite the loss, they would get the internet talking after making several references to both CM Punk and the backstage incident All Out, with Kenny Omega biting Pac's arm, something Ace Steel allegedly did to Kenny Omega during the altercation. Matt Jackson would also poke fun at Punk's botched buckshot lariat from the AEW title match with Hangman Page, before Omega mimicked the go-to-sleep taunt, and would also hit Punk's GTS finisher on Pac. Whilst there is yet to be a reaction from Punk himself, Dave Meltzer would take to Wrestling Observer Radio to claim that some people close to him weren't happy with the match, with him saying, "I know that there's people close to CM Punk that were, boy, they were not happy with that six-man tag match." The references in the match follow Kenny Omega's calls for fans to move on from the backstage incident, although the Elite's actions are a sign that they are yet to do so themselves. As with the recent Being the Elite episode that showcased Fuck CM Punk chants, many now feel that AEW are en route to a CM Punk versus the Elite feud, with the feeling being that if this wasn't the case, they would go out of their way to avoid any jabs given reported potential legal issues between the two parties. Punk was reportedly injured during the match with Jon Moxley All Out, with him later undergoing tricep surgery, which takes 4 to 6 months to recover from, so we're looking at January at a minimum before we know what his future holds. It's also worth noting that the Elite's Best of 7 series with Death Triangle for the Trios titles will end on January 11th at the Los Angeles Forum if it goes the distance, so make of that what you will. But do you think we're edging closer to an Elite versus CM Punk rivalry, and perhaps with FTR in tow? Let me know what you think in the comments down below. And before we get into our final story, I'm trying to hit 40,000 subscribers before Christmas, so if you're in a giving mood and you haven't done so already, make sure you click that subscribe button and maybe even turn on notifications if you fancy it, so you don't miss the latest wrestling news. But with that said, let's get into the final story, as MJF has called out UFC megastar Conor McGregor. As we discussed on last night's video, AEW world champion MJF has been caught up in a war of words with UFC star Paddy Pimblett, who's been taking the lightweight division by storm with his impressive fighting skills and his trash-talking persona. Max would then call the baddie a dollar store Conor McGregor during an interview with ESPN, and well, now the real Conor has responded. Reacting to the interview on Twitter, Notorious would defend his fellow MMA fighter and would say, "A dollar store Conor is still worth millions. Let's go, young Paddy Pim. Don't know who this other clown is." As expected, MJF would then respond to McGregor with some harsh words of his own, referencing Conor's recent bulk up during his time away from the octagon, and he would say, "I'll f*** the Conor clone up, then I'll wipe my ass with the original. Stay in your lane, you roided up leprechaun. You can't hang with the AEW world champion. Hashtag better than you." Both Paddy and Max have called for a confrontation at the upcoming AEW London show in 2023, which does seem likely at this point, although an appearance from McGregor does seem far more unlikely. With that said, Conor would be a huge get for All Elite Wrestling were they able to pull it off, and he would undoubtedly be the biggest mainstream star that they could get. I seem to be making a lot of comparisons between MJF and Steve Austin as of late, but if we go back to 1998, one of the things that took Stone Cold to a whole new level was his confrontation with boxing megastar Mike Mike Tyson, and were AEW able to emulate this with McGregor, it could be huge for both the company and MJF as an individual. With that said, McGregor has declared his intentions to re-enter the USADA testing pool in preparation for an upcoming UFC fight, with his full-time goal being to return to the octagon rather than a wrestling ring. Whilst I can't see it leading to a match, a back-and-forth promo between MJF and Conor McGregor would be absolute gold, so let's hope this Twitter war can lead to something somewhere down the line.